so happy to be here. This wonderful weather. God remember, just Mr. Roosevelt. How are you?
Germany and the United States of America.
I should say were 13 families from the Rhineland. They were followed by millions of their countrymen, men, women, and children, who became a strong thread running through the fabric of America. German Americans have meant so much to the development of this nation. And today, German-American friendship is vital to the security and freedom. We and the rest of our allies must continue to have the courage and mutual trust to do what is necessary to maintain peace and security in Europe. We decided in December 1970 would require the modernization of NATO's deterrent forces. So far, the Soviet Union has not been willing to negotiate a fair and verifiable arms reduction agreement with us. Seek the elimination of these weapons, and we will continue our unflagging efforts to reach an acceptable agreement. But if the Soviet intransigence continues, we must, for our part, we remain convinced that a strong NATO alliance remains the key to European peace and German-American cooperation. Goodwill our people hold for the Federal Republic of Germany runs just as deep as ever. By resolution of both our Congress and the German Bundestag,
we commemorate the arrival of the first German settlers in Philadelphia 300 years ago, and you, Mr. President, proclaimed that day as a day which we all made to the building of the American nation. But I further want to express the gratitude of us Germans towards the American people for what they did after two world wars. And I have only to recall millions of care parcels which were sent from America to Germans when we were airlifted of 1948-49, which saved the freedom of Berlin. Today, we are partners in the North Atlantic Alliance, the most efficient alliance to become friends, because they will realize that we, the Germans, and you, the Americans, have much more in common than most of them have been aware of.
Representatives of the countries to meet each other, but for young students. And this is, I'm very happy. I think you made an initiative in 1982 to foster an exchange program between the United States and Europe. And this has turned out very well. That changed, of course, my views about America, the fundamental way. You see, they have the same problems as you have. They try to solve them in a decent way. Well, next wave. Invite a number of American students who study in Germany. Had studied in America returned to Germany. And there was not one single student who had not become a friend of the other. It works really. It's the best way.
We just commented in here that we just realized we have new China here in the cabinet room. Good to see you. Well, welcome. I think it goes without saying that this visit is an important symbol of German-American partnership. That, as we've already stated, we are joined by common values and interests. Particularly appropriate that you come, of course, during this tricentennial year. We're grateful for the lasting contributions of German Americans and look forward to them. And regret my schedule precluded Philadelphia, but delighted that the Vice President will be there. So I wish you a very pleasant journey across America.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Your years of illustrious public service are well known to us, your contributions to peace and freedom. So,
repeat what I just said in public. I'm really very grateful to you, Mr. President, for the invitation you have extended to me and to the Vice Chancellor, and for the opportunity to visit America again, a country to whom I really owe a great deal. I do not have to underline the alliance and the necessity for the maintaining the alliance.
Start the car. Thank you. What about the briefing book? Right, I had nothing there.